Hello YouTube, and welcome back to Let's Play Episode 2 of... Wait, no. Let's Play Captain Toad Treasure Tracker, Episode 2. After Dragon Age Revenge, we're going on to Farewell Pirate Peak. This is going to be another one of those little cutscene type things, and... Oh no! Am I still riding atop Dragonin? Oh, nice! I can breathe fire. That's awesome. I can also raise if I'm going up and down. This is awesome. I am riding atop a massive beast. Very nice indeed. I can't really do much else, and there's no alternate view on the gamepad or anything. It's just that guy. This is very fun. Just being this massive beast, and that was awesome. I really enjoyed that. I might go back to that sometime off screen, just because that was really fun. Nice. Alright. That's a great way to say farewell to Pyro Peak. Alright, now to the Spin Wheel Cog Ruins. Intriguing, I admit.
Here I go!
Yeah, apparently here we go. Alright, cool. Let's see. Don't wanna hit that guy? Might as well, just to get past him. Don't wanna spin anything until I've fully explored where I can go without spinning it. Because, you know, there's probably secrets somewhere. I can't really see very well, even if I zoom in. Unless there's a thing behind here. Is this a secret? Oh, there is a secret here. Haha, golden mushroom. I'm going to assume that because of how secret-y that was, that is what my mission is. The secret mission and whatnot. So let's see. Well, let's pull this up. That's just going to be another, turnips to help me get past him. Which, honestly, I probably missed a... what am I doing? I can't get up through there. I probably missed another crystal. Or the first crystal. On this other side. Right here. Okay, so that's just spinning that one. Which works out right there. Which, actually... to get this one, I'm just gonna... Never mind. I was gonna say I'm gonna throw that turnip. But I did not take enough time to do that correctly. So let's see. I'm just gonna run past these guys. I don't want to use the turnip on them. Because, you know, that's mean and animal cruelty and whatnot. And it's not an animal, so it's not actually animal cruelty, but you know what I mean. So let's see. I have to come through here. Get that crystal. And, there is another crystal that way. And this is the second one, which means that other one's going to be the first one. Clearly. And I'm just going to use the turnip. There's no turnips. Okay. That's close. Let's see. Move that back that way. So I can get to that crystal. I guess I could have seen that if I had just turned that camera the way that I have it now. Alright, so now I need to... yeah, I'm gonna have to, but I just want to test to make sure... Oh, hey, there's coins down there. That's nice. But I just wanted to make sure that I couldn't do it that way. So, let's see. If I turn this that way? No, that's not gonna be enough. If I turn it back this way, then I can go from the other side and get in there. Oh, that was bad timing. All right, so yeah, and then go around this way. And you know, you can see that path, right? I don't need to explain it step by step. I can just show you. All right, now I get those coins. Now I actually have to be careful on this part. And yeah, I can tell that purple pipe. Is gonna be what gets me there, or gets me the last crystal. Time these right. There we go. And then go to the bottom of the screen, or bottom of the map. And yeah, turn the camera angle a bit better. Get some more coins, potentially for a one-up. What's this? Oh, and a mushroom to aid me on my way back to the power star. Coin, and then blue toad giving me that gem. And I got 103 coins, so that means I got a 1-up. And I got the golden mushroom earlier, so that is fantastic. Unless the mission is don't get hit, which I actually doubt it is, because that's what the last mission was. The mission might actually be collect a certain amount of coins, which is why I'm taking the time to collect all these coins. I really hope it's like 100, or like 110, and not like 113, because I only got 112. But you know what I mean? Probably, kind of, a little bit. Found the hidden golden mushroom. Yes, that's what I did. Huzzah! Alright, and the stamp or whatever. And did I say sticker at some point? Oh wow, I unlocked 3 levels. I unlocked wind up stairs, up and down terrace, and a clear pipe puzzleplex, which is going to be the final mission, probably, of this one. So there's just going to be these 3 more. Yeah. All right. So now the wind up stairs, which I'm not sure if that wind up is referring to the enemies that are sort of winding up before they attack, or something else. That floor looks like there's going to, like, drop spikes out of them. Or not drop spikes, but, like, have spikes pop out of them or something, but apparently not. Let's kind of zoom in, make things a little bit easier. What's a better angle? I guess I didn't really need much of a better angle, but oh well. Oh, right, because that's going to take me up to this part. Come on, get a bunch of coins, get a bunch of coins, and ooh, that was close. Nice timing, self. you know, always good to congratulate yourself on easy stuff every now and then. And okay, just making sure I can't. Oh, there's the wind up thing. Can I No, okay. That would've been cool if I could use the touchscreen to do that. Let's see. Can I do anything on the other side? I can't really see on the other side. I guess I can't. So wait. Oh, that's right. That I didn't need to go up here. I can go that way. And get some more coins on that side. Get some more coins right there. Get some more invisible coins right there. And there's a gem in there. So let's see. How am I going to get that gem? I'm going to have to go through there, obviously. Don't even care about that enemy or the power star right now. Let's see. What's up here? Just coins. And then I can just bounce on that guy to get that. But then how do I get in there, down there, because it looks like I should be able to, oh hey, there's that wanted bird picture, poster, or, hold on a second, because if I, oh wait, no, that's just the power star, that's making a shine. I was thinking, like, if I, do I, like, shine something on that, but, alright, so how do I get in there to get that gem, do I, oh, okay, there we go, I see it now. From here, you can actually go back, or, oh, wait, did I actually, oh, I made it in there before I even realized that, that I did. Nice. So yeah, then you just come up here to, get the power star. Nice, that was a nice level. I enjoyed it. I like that a portion of the challenge was something that was out of your control, so that it was something that, you just had to work with, or, like, work against. And, oh, found the hidden gold mushroom. Did I get that? I did not get that. Where's the hidden gold mushroom then? Is it like somewhere back where I started or something? Oh, I can't okay, there we go. There's the zoom in. So yeah, it's not there, obviously. Intriguing. Where would it be? Where would I hide a gold mushroom if I could hide one in this stage? Maybe. No. Let's get a bunch of coins just for fun. Let's see. I'm expecting one of those, like, hidden gold, pull up things. Like, not the turnip, but, let's see. Because I can kind of see. Oh, hey, there's a hidden Luigi down there. That's cool. I wonder if there's, like, hidden Luigis in multiple stages, like in maybe even all the stages, perhaps. Intriguing. But, yeah, not there. Oh, wait, no, I'm not supposed to drop down there. That's where I came from. Alright, so, hidden gold mushroom. I feel like it would have something to do with that, wanted Birdo picture. Not Birdo, but a Wingo. Over here, there we go, that's where it is. Someplace where you don't need to go, essentially, is where you would hide something like that. So huzzah! And I'm glad I actually had to defeat that enemy, and it wasn't, like, something interesting, like, oh, do you have to beat the level without defeating him, or something like that. So yeah, found the hidden gold mushroom. Nice. And, ooh, that's new and interesting. I want to check that out right now. Where's this? The mummy me maze? Intriguing. This is new and stuff. So I am a mummy, apparently. And apparently Captain Oh, never mind. I was gonna say, and apparently Captain Toad, but I was not Captain Toad. So it's one of these where the mummy is chasing me and wow. He is right on my tail. Okay, but then if I just maneuver correctly, then I can avoid them. I was just trying to see if I could get him to hit the piranha plant. So yeah, I definitely could have gotten more coins if I had just done this a little quicker, clearly. That was really nice. I'm definitely going to enjoy doing that again, if I ever do get to do that again. So that was fun. I liked it. I like those kind of challenges. It's like the Shadow Mario from, I think, Super Mario Galaxy is where that challenge originated, where it obviously just follows your moves, but it follows your moves, but add the delay. So then you just have to keep moving in order to do it. Okay, so let's look at this. I can only drop off one of these sides at first. So where do I want to start? Might as well start on this side. And of course, that's not where I wanted to land, but close enough. Am I going to avoid it? Okay, good. That's very close. Let's see, what's that going to do? Ah, that's going to move those things. And I'm assuming that I will be able to, like, make my way all the way through this place. Like, it doesn't really matter which side I start on. I'm sure it's going to let me be able to walk around all over the place. I'm going to assume my mission is probably not to kill these guys, but since I've already killed a few of them, I'm just going to keep killing them. I'm assuming my mission is not to kill them, because I'm not really gaining much by killing them. Like, I'm not using them to throw, like I just did, like, to throw into each other. So it wasn't really necessary to defeat them. And okay, so that's just where the power star is. So then how do I get it back up to the other side? Oh no. I trapped myself in here. So now I have to finish it. Oh well. I'm just going to be coming back again for the final mission. It's either going to be don't kill them or kill them all. Probably. Because again, you don't really gain anything by killing them. Cleared using switches 3 times. That's totally different than I was expecting. And oh, I only got 1 gem. I need to get... Where's the other 2? I mean, I'm sure I could have seen the other 2 if I just looked for them. Yeah, they're right there. So, wow, I could have just walked over and collected that other one. Right there. So then, where would I get that one? Oh, I can, throw these guys at them. At the gem to get that one. Let's see, is that gonna be a waste of one of my switches? Probably not. So then I can just throw it at that one. Okay, so then... How did I get up there? I need to go back this way. And then... Pull this switch? Or not pull this switch, but push that switch. And then... It's that one over there. So, yeah, that worked out pretty nicely. That was only 3 switches, right? I probably could have done it in 2 if I just... paid a little bit more attention. I wasn't trying to get the gems. Nice. That's cool. I like that the second time is generally faster than the first time. And yeah, they're using switches 3 times. Or do they mean specifically 3 times, not necessarily under 3 times? That'd be interesting. Anyways, now the clear pipe puzzle plex. It's gonna be. I'm sure this is gonna take me like 2 or 3 tries, because it does actually seem a little bit more difficult. And oh wow. Alright, this is a nice reference to Super Mario 3D World. I'm actually just looking at the background of this place. It actually does look pretty nice. But, anyways, I can't actually zoom in. I'm gonna get so lost in here. Oh, great, and there's fuzzies in here, which is understandable, because that's usually what the danger in these puzzle plexes. What am I gonna have to do for that? I'm gonna have to get, like, a star or something. Nope, that was close. Almost got hit again. So there's the gold mushroom. Oh, there's a pickaxe. Huh. Alright, so let's see. Where am I gonna use that pickaxe? I don't want to use it on the fuzzies. I want to use it on the, on the spinies. So let's see. Where am I gonna have to go? What would be faster? Let's see. Gonna have to go down back the way I just came. Probably. Can I make it? Can I make it? Can I make it? Can I make it? Yeah. Nice. Alright, where am I going? Oh, this is actually good timing. Good incidental timing. Let's see. So then let's just go back to where I was coming from. Oh boy, yeah. And again, good timing. Not intentional timing, obviously. But good incidental timing, like I already said. Alright, where am I going to get that one? To get that golden mushroom? I think I have to already be at the, yeah, at the power star to get that golden mushroom. Which means it's basically just like a time, not necessarily waste, because I'm assuming, you know, that's the mission to get the golden mushroom. Or just a certain amount of coins. Or potentially don't kill any fuzzies, or don't get hit by any fuzzies, and, oh, that was bad. You know, don't do what I just did, basically. But let's see, let's go get that gold mushroom. Very, very nice level. And especially the music is very nice and relaxing. Oh, wait, going the wrong way. Alright. Go down. I need a better angle on that. Because, yeah, that would have been a great time to have a mushroom. Oh, no. Okay, I can just go down to time that. Alright. Maybe not the best timing, but good enough. And huzzah! I made it! Hopefully it's not don't get hit. I really hope it's not don't get hit. Please do not be not get hit. collected 70 coins! Nice, and I collected 80. Very glad I got that golden mushroom, because I obviously would not have made it without that golden mushroom. Right? Because a golden mushroom's like 50 or something? Alright. And then, yeah, on the trail of the Great Bird. So that's gonna be the next episode. So yeah, very nice episode. I enjoyed that. Especially the farewell Pyro Puppy. That was fun. Might as well do it again. Because I've got time to make this episode like 20 minutes rather than 17. This is so fun. And so I guess I have to fire then? Or like fire at the blocks in order to get the coins out of them? Probably, something like that. And I'm not sure if this is actually counting towards my my one-ups and stuff, or if it's just for the fun of collecting coins, because this actually is really fun. But I couldn't get those on the side. Interesting. Huh. Very nice. But, so, yeah. Because I can't get any coins or anything. I wasn't actually paying attention to if that gave me any extra lives. But oh well, it was still very fun nonetheless. So I'm guessing two more episodes. I could probably just put the finale, like the final boss or whatever, on that last episode. But I'll probably just have two more episodes rather than just one. Anyways, that's going to be it for this episode. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.